Hello there. Do you know just how many creatures there are in the world? All those lovely animals, all so different from one another. Rhinoceroses, elephants, squirrels, rabbits, owls, kittens, puppies. Or the plants that cover the earth. The huge green forests. The colorful flowers. Roses. Daisies. Poppies. We love to look at their unique colors and shapes and smell their fragrances. Sweet cherries and ripe red tomatoes. Peaches and so many others are all wonderful blessings. There are more beauties in the world than just the plants and animals that live on the land. The deep blue sea that covers so much of the earth is a hidden world of wonders. Countless creatures, from colorful clownfish to oysters, from crabs to coral, inhabit this wonderful world. So, in the light of all this order, balance, and beauty that we see in nature, we need to ask ourselves some important questions. How did so many different kinds of animals come to be? How were the mountains, rivers, and seas formed? Why does nature have such balance and order? From whom did animals learn how to survive? Where did the trees learn how to produce such delicious fruit? And we who see and know these things, how did we come to exist? People are generally offered two different explanations for all this. Some claim that everything in the world came to be by itself and by chance. This view is known as the theory of evolution. The father of this theory was a man named Charles Darwin, who lived 150 years ago. Many thinkers and scientists oppose this theory and maintain that the order in the world and in living things did not happen by itself, but is the work of an all-powerful creator. And this all-powerful creator is God. That is the true answer, because all living things in nature, with all their special features, prove the existence of a creator. Let's look at an example to see why. Come on, let's go for a little walk on the seashore. The sea was a bit rough this morning, but it's not so choppy now. You know that when the waves strike the shore, they shift the pebbles and grains of sand, and that this causes bumps and sand dunes to form. But there is something else on this beach. Do you know what it is? A sand castle. Just look what a wonderfully designed castle it is. It has a door and towers and is surrounded by high walls. A moat has even been dug around it and filled with water, just like a real castle. Now, let's ask ourselves this question. Could this castle have been formed by chance, just by the waves striking the shore, or by the wind, without any human hand touching it? Of course not. The castle has been built with such attention to detail that someone must have constructed it deliberately. It has an obvious, intricate design, and we all know that such a design could only be the work of an intelligent being. Such design cannot come into existence by chance. So, when we look at nature and the living things in it, we must look at it in this way. Just as a sandcastle cannot come into being by chance, so the living things in our world, with all their complex structures,